Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the City of Fontana's 2021 State of the City program.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the City of Fontana and the Fontana Chamber of Commerce 2021 State of the City event. Can you believe it?
Thank you.
This is our 24th year and 24th event as the Chamber of Commerce and the City's partner together to do this, and we're so proud to bring you this event virtually and by video production to assure that everyone in the City of Fontana can hear the great news about our beautiful city. While there's no audience and we have numerous challenges ahead of us, we are up for the challenge. I want to thank those of you who made this event possible. It's always gracious and kind of so many of our sponsors. But to get started, I'd like to introduce a dear friend of mine, the senior pastor of Water Life Church, to give us the invocation. Please join me in welcoming Pastor Dan Carroll.
First, I want to welcome all of you to Water of Life. Thank you for being here with us. Unusual crowd for me, but we're glad to have you. So this has been a trying year, has it not? It's been a trying year for all of us. And whenever you talk about this year, and we were just sitting in the back talking about all the people we've lost, all the people that we've known, and each of us in the room, I'm certain, have known somebody that we've lost this year, and that's It's been a long, painful year. So we do a lot of praying around here. We do a lot of believing that it's going to get better. And for me, with the City of Fontana, I just want to say thank you to all of you who are so strategic here in the City of Fontana to make it a place that people can thrive. Because in the midst of COVID, in the midst of the struggle, there's been so many really good things that have happened. I drove down Sierra one day, and the police officers were out in the middle of the street directing traffic, and I said, "What's happening?" And they said, "Well, you guys are doing a food giveaway," and there were so many people that it backed up all the way up to the city council chambers on Sierra. And so it wasn't just us giving away food. There were highway patrol officers out working with our people, and we feed about 1,000 people a week down at our CityLink offices. But it's just the relationship we have with the City of Fontana is fantastic. We want to help the people of Fontana. You want to help the people of Fontana. So we are really grateful to partner with each of you. So let me pray before you begin today and just say thank you, God, for the City of Fontana. Thank you for our leaders. Thank you for our county supervisors. Thank you for the people that invest their lives, their finances, their time into the City of Fontana. We are so grateful to be in a city that thrives in the midst of a struggle, that doesn't give up, God, and that keeps pressing on and pressing in. And we believe for this year and ask you for this year that you would make this year a way better year than last year. And we pray for those people that are struggling right now in the hospitals and for families that have lost loved ones, that your hand would be deep on their hearts, God. We know there's so much pain, so much sorrow, so much struggle, so much loss this year, Father, that we've never experienced anything like this before. But we want to say we're grateful to you that we can run to you, that you're always there for us, that you care for people that are hurting and struggling. And I pray for each of the people in the city of Fontana and the outlying areas, the people that invest in our communities, that your hand would be on their lives and that they would be well aware of your presence and attentive to all that you say, Father. In the midst of the struggle, you said you were ever-present help in a time of need. And so we just thank you for that. Thank you for the city of Fontana. Thank you for our mayor, our city council members. Father, we pray that you would bless them this year. This would be a year, even in spite of the struggle, that we would all grow together in all that you have for the city. And thank you, thank you, thank you, Father. In the name of Jesus, amen. Bless each of you. Have a great meeting.
Thank you very much, Pastor Dan. We appreciate you allowing us to be in your home today and filming this and being a part of that. On a personal note, Pastor Dan has some of the cutest grandchildren in the whole wide world. They happen to be my grandchildren, so we appreciate what he does for us. I'd like to take a moment and introduce for our Pledge of Allegiance this afternoon, the Mayor Pro Tem of the City of Fontana. Happens to be a wonderful young man, a man that I am tremendously proud of. He is my son. So welcome to the stage, Councilman Mayor Pro Tem Philip Cothran.
I think you forgot to mention I'm your favorite councilman, correct? All right. If you guys don't mind joining with me, go in and stand as we do our Pledge of Allegiance together as we honor our flag and our country. So please place your right hand over your heart if you may. And ready? Begin. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, my favorite councilman. As always, this event would be not near as wonderful and fantastic without our sponsors. It takes a lot of people, a lot of effort, a lot of things that go on behind the scenes. And our sponsors play a critical role in keeping Fontana moving forward. We could not do this without our sponsors, and this year we would like to recognize them in a very, very special way.
Thank you for being a friend. Travel down a road and back again. Your heart is true, you're a pal and a confidant. I'm not ashamed to say, I hope it always will stay this way. My hat is off, won't you stand up and take a bow? And if you threw a party, invited everyone you knew, you would see the biggest gift would be from me, and the card attached would say, thank you for being a friend. Thank you for being a friend. Thank you for being a friend. Thank you for being a friend.
Would you think if I sang out of key? Would you stand up and walk out on me? lend me your ears and I'll sing you a song, and I'll try not to sing out of key. I get by with a little help from my friends. I get by with a little help from my friends. Oh, I can try with a little help from my friends.
What would you do when my love is away?
Does it worry you to be alone?
How do I feel at the end of the day?
Are you sad because you're on your own?
I get by with a little help from my friends. Yeah,
I get high with a little help from my friends.
Ooh, I'm gonna
try with a little help from my friends. Do you need anybody?
I need somebody to love.
Could it be anybody?
Somebody to love.
Now presenting our gold level sponsors.
'Cause you gotta have friends. The feeling's oh so strong, yeah, you got to have friends to make that day last long. I had some friends, but they're gone. Something came and took them away, and from the dust till the dawn, here is where I'll stay, standing at the end of the road, boys, waiting for my new friends to come. I don't care if I'm hungry or poor. I've got to give me some of them, because you got to have friends. La 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 la. Friends. Oh, yes, you've got to give yourself some friends. That's right, friends. Talk about friends. Oh, yeah, friends. That's right, friends. Talk about friends. Oh, yeah.
Technology has changed the way we live. Emerging technologies are erasing the boundaries that separate people, places, and ideas.
For more than 25 years, Crown Castle has been building and maintaining the infrastructure that supports this new way of life.
Towers
keep us connected,
instantly delivering voice, text, and data to the devices we depend on.
Small cells improve coverage and set the stage for new advancements, like the Internet of Things,
smart city technologies,
and 5G.
Tying it together is our nationwide network of fiber,
bringing the entire world to us in the blink of an eye.
Here is where we find ourselves.
Providing the infrastructure that new innovation requires.
The space where transformative ideas thrive.
The connections that keep communities together, safe and growing.
We're Crown Castle.
The pathway to possible.
Thank you, Crown Castle, for your partnership. We appreciate all that your company has done for our community and what you've done for our chamber. And again, I want to thank all of the sponsors that you've taken care of and helped us to make this a successful year, been a great help to our community and to our city. But now, let's get started. Ladies and gentlemen, the Fontana Chamber of Commerce is proud to bring you the 2021 State of the City Address.
Music is a blessing me. He wants to, he wants to, he wants. really like that just now. Let's act like we really enjoy that. Welcome to our first virtual but 24th annual State of the City address. Thank you to Water of Life Community Church for allowing us to use this wonderful venue. This amazing church has invested their time and resources in improving the quality of life, not only in our great city, but in our entire region and the world. Thank you, Pastor Dan, for your invocation and your leadership. Before we go any further, I would like to introduce our great city council. First, our Mayor Pro Tem, Philip Cothran. Councilmember John Roberts. Councilmember Jesse Sandoval. And our newly elected Councilmember Peter Garcia. Councilmember Garcia isn't new to helping Fontana. He is a Fontana former Planning Commission. He's a former Fontana Unified School District member, a scientist, and now a Fontana council member. Because of his vast knowledge of our great city, he was able to hit the ground running, and I'm excited to watch him work. I encourage everyone to get to know him. I would like to also introduce our treasurer, Janet Kohler Brooks, our city clerk, Tony Lewis, and on the job for just 9 months, our new city manager, Mark Denny. I want to also recognize our city employees, our business partners, our vendors, consultants, and various regional agencies. They all work hard, and nothing happens without them. This year brings new beginnings, and for some, that new beginning is retirement. I don't want to miss the opportunity to acknowledge a few people that have been critical to the success of this city over the years. Deputy City Manager Chuck Hayes. Deputy City Clerk Karen Corliss. And Community Development Director Zai Akbar. They will all be deeply missed. For those of you who were not aware, our great County 5th District Supervisor, Josie Gonzalez, with 16 years of service, has fulfilled her term. She has been a friend to this city. We look forward to seeing what the future will bring to her as she continues to serve those she loves. Thank you to the great Fontana Chamber of Commerce for your service to our business community. I want to give special thanks to Fontana Chamber of Commerce Chairman Troy Linen, President Phil Cothran, and the new Executive Director, Andrea DeLeon. This state of city is a great reflection of the partnership between the city and the chamber. I also want to thank Stargazer Production from Center Stage Theater, directed by Todd Vigiletti. What a great opening. Stay tuned. The ending is even better. Please give them all a big hand. To say that 2020 presented challenges would be an understatement. There were wildfires, explosions, protests against racial injustices, and let's not forget a global pandemic. I don't want to make light of these hardships because many of them are still impacting our way of life. Our schools are still closed. Local businesses continue to be severely constricted and the job loss numbers continue to increase. Everyone has had to adapt to not only working from home, staying at home, but most concerning to me is the COVID-19 death rate. Despite these challenges, our city departments jumped into action to provide crucial services to our great public. The trials of maintaining physical and mental health as well as social injustice has taken its toll. On May 25th, the world witnessed the killing of George Perry Floyd Jr., an African-American man killed during an arrest. Derek Chauvin, one of the four arresting officers, knelt on Floyd's neck for 8 minutes and 46 seconds. His death triggered worldwide protests against the police brutality and called into question law enforcement's use of force. The entire nation's eyes were open and hearts touched. This outpouring prompted action toward a movement against the injustices that have been happening across our nation for years. Many cities exploded in anger and violence. But here in Fontana, there was a different story to be told. What started out as civil unrest actually led to many peaceful demonstrations as members of the community unified to end racial injustice. As a result, in true Fontana form, we recognize the need to specifically address social, economic, educational, and environmental disparities that are a result of racism. We took immediate action. On July 14, 2020, we, the City Council, and I unanimously declared racism as a public health crisis in Fontana. This proclamation allowed us to open discussions with community members such as businesses, educators, faith-based leadership, youth, and our police department. Through these discussions, we are initiating and supporting efforts that work toward promoting a fair and just society, eliminating barriers that reduce opportunities for residents of color, as well as purposely advancing justice, equity, diversity, and inclusion. Additionally, we have established the Police Chiefs Roundtable. This innovative collaborative was proposed by our former Parks and Recreation Commissioner, Felix Jones, and one of our great citizens, Christian Latuli, who led a peaceful, faith-based demonstration. The purpose of the Chiefs Roundtable is to provide much-needed input from city residents on enhancing the relationship between the community and the police. Right here in Fontana. I will be the first to admit that these have not been easy conversations, but they are necessary for us to move toward progress. This past November, I was appointed to serve on the San Bernardino County Transportation Authority's Equity Ad Hoc Committee. The committee will examine existing policies and projects through the lens of equity to identify issues and solutions. Along with our fight against racial injustice, we have made great strides in supporting and improving our infrastructure for education. Our Fontana Mayor's Education Coalition has worked hard this year to strengthen the partnership between the city, our schools, the business community, and other stakeholders. Our goal is to ensure our students don't miss a beat during this terrible pandemic. We are embracing the bold innovation about to occur in this city with Crown Castle, a communication infrastructure provider who is partnering with Fontana Unified School District and our city to provide high-speed internet access to more than 36,000 students at their homes and in their communities. This is exciting. This project will create the nation's first citizen broadband radio service, which is a private network dedicated solely to education. Establishing this network is a significant step forward in closing the digital divide. No doubt, Fontana is a national leader in solving the challenges of digital disparities in predominantly communities of color. Speaking of leaders, 2020 showed us that students are not only making a difference in our local community, but at a national level as well. The Mayor's Youth Advisory Council, also known as MIAC, partnered with the U.S. Conference of Mayors to support voter engagement. In this last election cycle, MIAC launched an initiative with the goal to encourage, educate, and motivate eligible youth to register and vote early. I'm proud of their accomplishments, and I look forward to seeing what they do in the future. Fontana, we are already a leading city in the Inland Empire, but we are well on our way toward becoming a leading city in the state of California and throughout the United States. Let me show you.
The city of Fontana has emerged as an economic driver for the Inland Empire, resulting in increased business investments citywide. With a growing population of more than 214,000 residents and a market access of more than 23 million people, Fontana continues to be a prime location for new businesses. Northgate Gonzales Markets, a California-based grocery chain with more than 41 stores throughout Southern California, is soon to be the newest business addition to the city of Fontana, where they plan on taking advantage of the vast opportunities Fontana has to offer.
We've been looking to open a store in Fontana for the last 5 years, and we believe that Fontana residents would absolutely love what we offer and what we bring to the community. So 5 years ago, we really started to, you know, drive around the city and find locations that we thought were appropriate for our store. Luckily, we were able to land a great site. We're very excited to get open. I've seen our relationship with the city of Fontana as a partnership. As much as we were very excited about opening a store in Fontana, the city staff and the city leaders have been just as excited to have us open a store in their city. And frankly, the process has been wonderful. Our group and the city staff have really been working diligently with real desire and embracing our process as well as theirs to really be able to facilitate the opening. So it's been a wonderful partnership. We're very excited and very professional group. You know, we're here and we're very excited about the construction and then the opening.
In today's market, business leaders must balance the responsibility of employee health and safety, as well as financial implications, all while building resilient teams in a time of extreme uncertainty. World-class manufacturers like JM Eagle are doing just that. As the world's largest plastic pipe manufacturer, JM Eagle is hard at work leading in product technology innovation while meeting the business demands across a variety of industries.
We produce water pipe, sewer pipe, and electrical conduit. You know, a lot of times we think, oh, this is just plastic pipe, but when you dig deeper, you know, it's the essence of life. We bring clean drinking water to the folks' homes, sanitary sewer, and electricity. So this plant here produces ag pip, C900, C909 for water transmission and gravity sewer. This plant specifically ships pipe all over the West Coast. We ship into Washington State. I know we produce pipe here for the Hanford Nuclear Plant, for Tato Farms in Idaho. Big, big impact. Fontana is the perfect showcase location. Right here in Fontana, we put in our first inline PVCO. PVCO is the future of plastic pipe. It uses 40% less material to produce a product that is seismically resistant and by far stronger than competitive pipe products. And I can't think of a place where we have a better relationship than we do right here with folks in Fontana, which is why, you know, we continue to expand our operations here and will continue into the future.
Being at the epicenter of e-commerce, manufacturing, and logistics positions Fontana as the premier location for industrial markets, as well as their respective supply chains.
Our main market, right, our niche is here, the West Coast, or mainly California, actually, right? Because this is part of our competitive advantage to be closer to this customer. So our lead times for delivering products are lower. As we sell locally, we also buy locally, which means that the most of our suppliers are around here. One of the challenges that we are facing right now, to find and to keep skilled labor like craftsmen, electricians, mechanics. So to address that situation, we enter in a partnership with Intech, and they have a terrific college there, the Intech Center, offering exactly training to have these skilled people. So it's a very good partnership.
Training the talent that companies will surely need if they aim to thrive in the future has become a defining issue for business leaders today. A well-trained and adaptive workforce is critical now more than ever. This is where Chaffey College comes in.
So currently, some of the most in-demand skills for our area is logistics, right? You see all the Amazon centers, you see the freeways, we're close to the Port of Los Angeles, so logistics is number one. And we have programs that support logistics. Next is healthcare, also business and entrepreneurship programs. These are all very key to the development of our region and our area. In addition to the Fontana campus, we have the Intech Center. And so at the Intech Center, students can work on robotics, industrial maintenance, all sorts of interesting programs. Currently through the state, we have what's called the Promise Program, or what we call the Panther Promise. So if students come in, they're full time, they're taking all their classes, it's actually free. So there's a lot of things we offer to students in the city of Fontana that we're really proud of, and we think will help further industry as well as the careers of our students. Partnerships with industry are really key to everything we do. We have, as was mentioned, the partnership with California Steel. We're also looking to grow our partnerships with Kaiser Medical, Amazon. There are lots of different groups. Amazon, of course, there's a natural connection there to logistics. So we're exploring these partnerships. The way we work with industry is we actually have leaders and experts in the field at present who come and help us develop programs, examine our curricula, meet with the faculty and say, here's what the industry needs. And so then it's our duty to sort of respond to that and create programs that are thriving, that meet the needs of our students, and then can help the city develop. Chaffey College is committed to the ongoing success of our students, as well as to the economic development of the city, and we're looking forward to continuing that partnership.
I can't wait to see what the future holds for Northgate Market in the city of Fontana.
CSI is looking forward to continuing contributing to the wealth of the city of Fontana. Thank you.
On behalf of my coworkers here at the Fontana plant, I'd like to say thanks to the city of Fontana. Looking forward to continued investment and growth.
And our infrastructure must grow with it. We are the largest city in the largest geographic county in the U.S., and our population is expected to reach 280,000 by the year 2040. New residential and commercial development, along with easy access to major transportation corridors, are imperative to the success of our city and region. Fontana has become the hub for our region's growth in manufacturing, transportation, and logistics. Many think of these buildings as just warehouses, but they are job centers. I want to change the narrative right now. They are job centers. These job centers provide a wider range of employment, from entry level to highly skilled positions for our Fontana families, neighbors, and friends. We are working to attract restaurants, hotels, meeting facilities, and entertainment sites to the city. With the influx of these job centers, we are on our way to reaching our goal. State of California is doing a great job of regulating the emissions on all trucks. The Fontana Planning Department is doing an excellent job of meeting every federal, state, and local standards to keep our public safe when we approve these projects. So what are we gonna do to move our city forward? Let's start in the south. Soon in the southern region of Fontana, we will see 155 units of sustainable housing. I would like to thank related companies, Josh LaBarge Industries and Quality Management Group for investing in housing. I would also like to thank my colleagues on our council that voted to approve the adjacent Fontana Foothills Commerce Center project. As a result, This job center will be sharing the cost of construction for much needed infrastructure, creating an opportunity for real economic growth for this area. Speaking of future development, I've got a big announcement. I'm pleased to announce the construction and opening of the new Chaffey College South Fontana campus. That's right. This site will total approximately 14 acres on the west side of Sierra Avenue, south of the 10 freeway. This campus is expected to educate more than 6,000 students. The college is working on a master plan for this great new campus and will present a draft to the college governing board in May of this year. This project will attract restaurants, housing, entertainment, and retail. It's important to note that commercial development is interconnected. Each project assists us in developing more city amenities, such as the South Fontana Sport Park. We have already identified $13 million of the $19 million that we need to fund this park. But that's not all. You may have noticed construction on the 10 freeway, not too far from us. These are express lanes. They will extend all the way to the LA County line. The construction is expected to be completed by middle of 2023. The express lane projects are designed to help relieve the traffic congestion on all the freeways that surround us. Moving north on Sierra Avenue, across from our great Kaiser Permanente campus, known as the hospital, is the North Gate Gonzales Market. You've already heard a lot about them, but I want to reiterate how excited we are about their arrival. Now let's talk about the core of our city, which includes our downtown area. For years, we invested in our City Hall campus. Early additions included the renovation of the police department, construction of the Lewis Technology Library, and the Development Services Organization offices. But this past year, many new modifications were completed. First, we completed the solar installation to save energy by constructing overhead parking at our City Hall and Police Department. Then we expanded Miller Amphitheater to include special needs playground equipment, and with the great help from our business community and citizen donations, we built the Fontana Veterans Memorial, honoring our Fontana veterans who serve in our country's armed forces and are still serving all over the world, keeping us safe. We also renamed our Development Services Organization building, better known as the DSO building, to the David Wiener Development Center, building to honor one of the first developers who believed and invested in Fontana. But can you believe at the young age of 93, he is still investing and developing in our city? There is still more to come. Let's give David a big hand. The state of California is aggressively requiring all local governments to provide more housing to resolve the housing crisis in this state. We already have an approved housing project, which includes 29 units right on the corner of Nuevo and Arrow, with retail planned on the first floor. The developer of this project is not stopping with housing and retail, but now is planning office space in the same area to promote and support entrepreneurship for Fontana residents. Thank you, New Legacy. Additionally, this area is approved as an opportunity zone. This is going to allow us to bring more retail, housing, entertainment, and office space right in the downtown area. Our city has already begun partnering with Fontana's Women's Club to renovate their historic building. It is the second oldest building in Fontana. It will be redesigned as a restaurant meeting facility right across the street from City Hall. Upon completion, it will be operated by Chef Henry Gonzalez, who currently operates Spaghi's, a five-star restaurant located in Upland. Now, just down the street from the Women's Club is the nearly completed Central Park. This 13-acre sports facility includes 3 turf fields, ADA accessible playground, horseshoe pits, and a community garden. As we move north, you may recall the Fontana Housing Authority purchased approximately 5 acres of vacant land on the southwest corner of Sierra and Ramona to develop a 60-unit sustainable multifamily community construction. This construction is well underway and is expected to be completed this spring. This project is being developed and managed by Jamboree. Thank you, Jamboree. As I continue to move further north to Citrus and South Highland Avenues, I want to announce the new Fontana Square project developed by the Ladere Group. This project will bring 2 major hotels, a conference center, and 2 restaurants. I hear the project may include a brewery and an In-N-Out Burger. Just putting it out there. Right down the street, we are expanding our Fontana Auto Center to include a new Hyundai and Jeep dealership. Moving further north is a project that has sat in the waiting for more than 15 years, but received a jump start last year. Ventana. Gotta give it up for Ventana, you all. We are going to see the first phase of this project break ground sometime this year. The city is partnering with longtime Southern California home builder Frontier Enterprises and Jimmy Previty to bring housing, retail, and office space. The 41.5-acre Ventana specific plan will be a premier community with a Tuscan theme. The progress throughout this city is profound. These projects represent jobs that we will need as our population grows. I like to call it Fontana Works. According to a recent report from the County of San Bernardino Workforce Development Department, the top 5 sectors forecasted to grow in our city are transportation, office and admin support, sales, food preparation, and healthcare. I want to take a moment to pause right here. Experts are calling COVID-19 the great accelerator. It accelerated e-commerce and technology far beyond what economists predicted only 2 years ago. As you can see, the number of jobs in transportation and logistics far and away outpace all other industry sectors, signifying a tremendous demand. We cannot afford to ignore this fact. We must maximize our assets and build the strength of the market. We will remain laser focused on building our economy. We are bringing together representatives from the business community, associations that represent the various industrial sectors, and economic experts to assist us to ensure our community remains strong. COVID-19 has also accelerated the nation in other unexpected ways. The far-reaching impacts of COVID-19 have disproportionately impacted the least advantaged segments of our residents. Again, Fontana acted and will continue to take action. We were able to assist families struggling financially due to the effects of the pandemic by paying up 3 months' rent or mortgage payments through a grant awarded, funded through Housing and Urban Development, better known as HUD. As of December 2020, a total of 342 checks were issued, totaling $502,000. We are currently reviewing our options to provide more assistance in rent and mortgage payments. COVID-19 has not only affected us economically and physically, it has affected our mental health as well. We have conducted various interviews with local mental health professionals to assist us in understanding effects of the stress caused by COVID and social isolation. We continue to partner with our nonprofit groups and faith-based organizations on food drives to assist our residents with their food needs. Now I wanted to tell you about our efforts toward a population of our community that was already suffering before COVID from lack of resources, and that is our homeless. We continue our efforts to eliminate homelessness. We partnered with CityLink, a Water of Life program, to provide homeless resources and information. I'm so proud of our police department's efforts in addressing homelessness. We are working with Eric Gavin, founder of Open Door Community Partnerships. Eric and his staff are working closely with our officers to identify the chronic homeless and assist them with their needs. But we need housing. I need anyone who has capacity to house our residents to contact us immediately. I plan on convening developers and rental community owners to join us in our efforts to house people. We can help and change their narratives and outcomes. Fontana, we've been busy informing our nation that they cannot forget Fontana's needs. I joined with a newly formed coalition of California mayors to advocate for CARE Act funds. Unfortunately, a majority of funds were only sent to cities with populations over 500,000. Our goal, along with many others, is to get our state and federal leaders to provide funds for the shortfall we are experiencing as a city. Our budget has taken a significant hit to continue providing services to our residents without interruption. This council made a commitment not to lay off any employees. Instead, we adjusted pending projects and transactions for a later period. We still are conducting an analysis to determine what our financial picture will be. Nearly every day, I'm on a Zoom and conference calls with leaders from all over the United States, working to get the necessary resources for COVID-19 tests and vaccinations to our city as soon as possible. I want to remind our new president, governor, and all our congressional and Senate leaders to remember that in California, if you only help the large cities, you leave behind over 70% of the population of this state. I'm including in my request assistance in getting for our kids to get them back to school. Our kids are suffering. Many are falling further behind. I will not give up. Our council will not give up. And you shouldn't give up, because our children matter too. We are still Fontana together. I'm passionate about that because I see our children struggling, and that's not what we want to see. We want to work together to change that outcome. Now remember, we're still Fontana together, and it's woven into everything we do. The connections we make with one another, the support of the partnership with our local businesses. It's in our infrastructure investment, in our dedication to developing our workforce. We have a collective resolve to ensure the safety and well-being of every resident. We believe in inclusion, equity, and opportunity for all. We embrace the diversity of our people, markets, and social fabric where both business and community prosper. It's these hometown values that have helped to make us the leading city in San Bernardino County. But make no mistake, there are no quick fixes, and we have a lot of work ahead of us. There have been significant changes in our national economy that impact us all. Even the way we do daily business is different from just 1 year ago. So we must manage our resources carefully. We must forge key partnerships, look strategically at development, and work towards collective solutions. I want to reiterate our ability to move forward in this time of uncertainty and remain resolute on our goals is what has set us apart. Fontana, it's time to unify. Every day I pray for all of you, and I know you pray for me. So be proud, Fontana. We are a shining example of a high-quality, forward-thinking community that works. We couldn't do anything without you. My time in local government has taught me a few valuable lessons. We must work together to move forward. Fontana is open for business. These are scary times. We are not sure what the future holds, but it's gonna be all right. Fontana is gonna be all right. We're going to be there together and get through this together, but it's going to be all right. Hey, that sounds like a good sign, doesn't it? It's gonna be all right.
It's all right.
It's all right. It's all right. Have a good time. 'Cause it's all right. Oh, it's all right.
We got a move with love. When lights are low.
When lights are low.
Give yourself a chance.
Give yourself.